weight. I am now 22 weeks. I want to be noticeably pregnant, not that in between. About 2 months ago, I had a total meltdown. I felt so depressed and so sad, and I went out to dinner and I cried because my meal didn't come with chicken schnitzel and I was craving chicken schnitzel all day. So at Easter family dinner, I went into the bathroom and I sobbed so much, like I was just so sad and so depressed and just devastated that I didn't get my chicken schnitzel. And looking back on it, it's bloody hilarious because I sobbed and sobbed over chicken schnitzel. Literally, that's all it was. So yeah, I call it my chicken schnitzel meltdown. I don't think, I did have another little meltdown on the weekend, over the weekend. So last weekend, I cried because I've been emotional. I cried because I went to a shop and I couldn't decide on the colour of a chair, so the rocking chair in the nursery, and I just felt so sad and I just had to cry. it's not over chicken schnitzel. It was a very hard decision. There was only two kinds of rocking chairs, and anyway, I made the decision in the end and I'm very happy, and it's getting delivered in a couple of weeks. So that's an update. We bought a new rocking chair for the nursery, so everything's exactly the same as our last video, except yeah, I've got a new addition, so I'll show you that when it arrives. So 22 weeks, I just feel really emotional. I haven't been sleeping as good, not that my stomach is overly huge, because I feel comfortable in bed tossing and turning. It's my stomach hasn't gotten in the way of my sleep. But I find myself stressing, like I was stressing over the gift registry. So I'm gonna have a baby shower and the gift registry has been on my mind. Like thinking about bottles, like which bottles to get, or thinking about which camera to get for the nursery, so to put above the cot. The video audio camera, baby monitor. I still haven't chosen. there's little things that I'm stressing about, and I don't know, I think I'm just anxious and nervous and excited, and I feel like I ran on adrenaline today, like I was just so wound up. I feel really wound up, and I don't know if it's just the pregnancy hormones or I don't know, but I just feel a bit stressed. I don't know if it's because I know that soon I'll be on maternity leave and I can see the finish line coming. Not that it's going to be easy once I'm on maternity leave, and once the baby comes, it'll probably be a lot harder. Like it's leaving one job for another job, being a mum. I don't know, I'm a bit anxious. The past 2 weeks, I've been feeling kicks. So I was really upset because I have an anterior placenta, and people with the placenta at the back can feel kicks straight away. So my sister felt it straight away. She's been feeling it for a while and seeing the actual, like the bump moving. But for me, I didn't feel anything, and I just, like, I knew it was coming. I knew eventually I just had to be patient and it'll come. So the past 2 or 3 weeks, I have started to feel him move, which I can actually feel him right now moving. So good morning. Well, it's 10 o'clock at night. So good morning. Yeah. So I'm excited to feel him move. Yeah. During the day I can feel him, and then like on my way home, I'll feel him. When I'm lying down, he might kick. So yeah, it's really exciting. So Mark put his hand on my tummy. Whenever I feel it, like when I feel him moving or kicking, I put my hand on my stomach and I can feel it move. But I think it's because I can feel the internal movement, and then my hand, I know where he is exactly, so I know where to feel for him. But Mark has tried to feel it, and I'm like, there, did you feel that? He's like, no. There. He goes, no. There. He's like, no. So I don't think internally they're strong. Oh, internally I can feel them, or I can feel him, but Mark can't feel him yet, so my stomach mustn't be like, I know, it's just like a little tap, just like tapping. I thought it was tapping on the outside that I can feel, but sometimes I feel him almost like pushing down and like rolling. I don't know, it's like when you're in bed and you turn from left to the back, and then on your side, and like I feel like he's just turning. Yeah, so that's an exciting update. So I have to start thinking about my maternity leave, so I think I'm going to take a year off. I don't know when I'm going to start maternity leave. I stand all day, every day, so I don't know how my body's going to handle it, but I'll try and work up. Yeah, I'll try and see how I go. I've heard my feet might swell. I've heard that I might get bad sciatica, or I don't know. I don't know how I'll feel. I might take, so I'm due on the 18th of October 2019. I might take 2 weeks off, I might take three, I might take a month before baby's due, because he might come early, he might come 2 weeks early, I don't know. But yeah, I'm thinking maybe 3 weeks earlier, and I'll just see how I feel. I can always drop my days down if I swell too much or if I hurt too much. I'm thinking for my baby shower, August, a Sunday in August. So I don't know where to have it. I've got to choose where, what time, who. I've got to write a guest list. I've already started my gift registry because I just thought it's nice to get excited over things like items, and I can just cross it off the list and go, yep, it's there, because we've started to set up the nursery. Yeah, I'll just get things organized early so I don't have to stress about it later. My sister has her baby shower sooner anyway. Her baby shower will be on a Sunday in July, the first Sunday in July, so that'll be exciting. I can go to that and then have my own. We were going to have it together, but we've decided just to keep it separate. Half of our family is in Greece, they're all overseas, so they won't make it to her baby shower, but if I, if I do mine a little bit later, then they can all be there. Today is Thursday. So on Monday next week I have my obstetrician appointment, and I will probably bring you along. And that's the update.